What's going on, Weekend Hangover Nation? I'm your boy Surf, and I'm back. All right, so a draft is quickly coming upon us, and I want to talk about a few of the later round prospects. You know what I mean? I'll get a couple sleepers out there. I like me a sleeper. So today I want to talk about James Morgan. He's a quarterback at FIU. He's 6'4", 229 pounds. Morgan started his career at Bowling Green. He was recruited by head coach Dino Barbers and later played under Mike Jinks in his air raid style. Hey, I like throwing a rock around 60 times as much as the next guy, but it's not for everybody. So Morgan graduate transferred after his redshirt sophomore year at Bowling Green to Florida International. I only give that graduate transfer part in there because, man, he graduated from Bowling Green with a degree in law in 3 years. So he's got himself a nice head on his shoulders. I just want to toss that out there. All right, so Morgan transferred to FIU, and he put up really solid numbers immediately there, while putting his name on NFL Draft Radar. So you put up good numbers, you get there, man. So during his first season at FIU, he completed 65% of his passes for 2,727 yards with a really good 26-7 touchdown interception ratio. What I like about Morgan's game is he's tough, man. The type that'll run through a linebacker to get that first down. It's reported that Morgan suffered a knee injury before his senior season, and he played throughout the entire season without missing a single game. Like I said, he's tough. Toughness really shows up on tape. He eats contact really well without getting happy feet, and he's able to deliver strikes downfield while taking hits in the pocket. He's got a bit, in that regard, he's got a bit of a Big Ben / Cam Newton feel to it, at least in that regard to his game. He also has a cannon. He can get the ball to all three levels with no problem whatsoever, which, as you know, isn't just a nice weapon to have in a vertical threat, but it's nice for fitting the rock between linebackers, and that's something Morgan does with ease. Now, what concerns me about Morgan's game is he's frustratingly inconsistent. You get that a ton when you're watching later round quarterbacks, and man, he's got so much talent, but man, Morgan makes me want to pull my hair out. Worst part is, almost every single one of his inconsistency issues is directly due to his poor mechanics. He opens his hips, he's got terrible foot movement, he's a mess back there. On the non-mechanical side, I have to say he's got a terrible habit of locking in on a single target. He just doesn't do a good job of moving through his progressions. I mean, it happens. So while the mechanical problems are fixable, you get with a good coaching staff, man, he might be able to do something. The vision, I don't think an eye doctor on the staff can even fix that. So I love Morgan as a developmental prospect, a bit of that draft and stash style. And if you're going to take a flyer on a guy like that, I'd rather have a guy who can throw a fastball. At least you have something to work with. All right, guys, this has been another Weekend Hangover production. I'm your boy Surf. Take it easy, stay safe, and hit us up with a like, comment, subscribe. Catch you guys later. Peace.